The following program was recorded a few months ago, and it represents Elvis's last concert tour.
I'm going to see Elvis the Pelvis, and it's going to be great.
He is just the king.
The king.
He's the king.
The king of music.
King. He is the king.
He's the king. He's great. I love him.
He's the king.
He will always be the king, no matter what.
I think he's a good, clean fella.
I think any auditorium in the country that has Elvis has an experience that he never forgets, and it's one of the attractions that every building looks for. When Colonel Parker gives you the call that you have a date, after all that, it's just like you're in the Army. Everything is done by the numbers. And the arrival time is always kept at a minimum. Only a few people know what time he arrives or what airport he'll arrive in. And from the time he hits the ground until the time he's on that stage would be roughly about 8 minutes. When you feel that burst of excitement, of the enthusiasm of the crowd, you just feel as though God just landed.
I have been to his home many times, touched the gate and everything. That just turns me on just to do that. What's he going to do when I watch him tonight? They've got an ambulance waiting by.
If he said, come along, let's go, I wouldn't look back.
Imagine he'll still be as good looking as he always was, just older.
Hi, this is the town stage corner.
Hey, Jim.
I think when I first knew him, he wasn't playing the type of music I like, but now I think it's just all tremendous.
Yes, I was in love with him.
Oh, he's such a sexy person.
I'm not a spring chicken anymore.
He's great.
Jackson, wait a minute.
I've got a daughter about 12 years old, and I've talked about Elvis and about how great he was when I was growing up. She has no idea who the man is. And I think a kid can't grow up without knowing who Elvis Presley is.
We're retired people, and all ages come to see him, I think.
I think it's a lot of the flashy clothes he wears and everything, and it seems like all women like that.
I like the stuff he buys, the cars and all the rings, all the clothes, his quality. I mean, and I think he's a very religious person. I mean, very, but he's human. I mean, he cusses on stage, but that's human. I mean, but he's religious, like, he's nice to people. I mean, he's human.
One, two, two. Check. Check. One, two, two, two. Check. One, two. You leave it up.
Oh, I'm so nervous I can't stand it. He's so special and everything, and he's the best looking guy in the world.
This is about my 28th concert since 1972.
That was means to me a legend.
I'm so excited. I can't wait.
Ladies and gentlemen, Elvis in concert.
Giant photo album with some 25 color portraits of Elvis in his concert tours across America. The giant photo album sells for only $3. Then we have the giant Elvis portrait on portrait paper. Looks just like an oil painting for only $5. We have the smaller Elvis portrait also on portrait paper for only $3. Those great Elvis buttons, $2 each. the 11x14 color photograph of Elvis for only $3. Beautiful posters suitable for framing in beautiful color for only $3 each. Then everyone has a front row seat with a set of binoculars. We have those great binoculars for $5 each. And then we have two brand new Elvis super souvenirs. One is a beautiful Elvis necklace. All the ladies want to wear an Elvis necklace for only $5. And then in limited supply this evening, a beautiful Elvis gold belt buckle for $10. All at the Elvis super souvenir concession stands in the outer lobbies. The vendors are in the audience. You have plenty of time before this evening's concert begins to get your memento of your evening with Elvis and get one of the great Elvis super souvenirs.
I want saturation to cover the whole damn spot. I don't want to open the place here. I don't want a door uncovered. I want everything with men.
No problem. What do we have, about 45 vendors? 50?
We better have. I called the manager and asked him to get us about 50 vendors.
Okay.
So plus the roadies, we should have good saturation here. Colonel wants it that way. Let's go.
Elvis super souvenir. Hey, take home a little Elvis. Elvis super souvenir is here. Everybody loves Elvis. Oh, we got a limited supply for tonight only. Everybody spend money.
Yeah.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. If you haven't guessed by now, you're on television. And so don't let the lights and cameras throw you. But they are hot, I'll tell you for sure. I'm going to do the first song that I've recorded. We had a guitar, electric guitar, and a bass, and that's all. And one like this.
Well, that's all right, Mama. That's all right with you. That's all right, Mama. Just any way you do, well, that's all right.
That's all right.
That's all right.
He was on TV and he was kissing the polio poster child for that year. And I told my mother I'd give anything to be in her shoes, and I would to this day still yet.
Do the chairs in your parlor seem empty in there? Do you gain?
And I bought my ticket to a girl that lives here in Omaha. And I was very lucky because she got 20 the day that the tickets went on sale. And she offered me to my sister and I, and I was thrilled because I've been waiting to see him for so long. And I was supposed to go see him in Wichita, Kansas, December the 27th of last year. And I had to go in the hospital for emergency surgery.
and was unable to go. And so this means the world to me, because he's the greatest person that has ever walked, and he sings beautiful, and I would never pay to see anybody else, and I haven't, and I won't. This is the only one, because I love Elvis with all my heart.
Is your heart filled with pain? Shall I come back again? Tell me, dear, are you lonesome tonight?
Taken to the hospital, and fortunately she was released. They kept me overnight. She required 4 stitches under her chin, and she's got multiple bruises. I've got 23 plus on my back. It's like Jaws got a hold of me. But thank God our children were not at home at the time, or I don't think they would be here. They were with their grandparents because their rooms were completely totaled out. And I don't really feel like standing around too much, but we still came down to see the king.
He's honest. That's the main thing. He's honest. And he's got vibes, you know? And that's what we enjoy. This is my son, and he's been an Elvis fan since he's been 3 years old.
Well, I've seen him about 5 times. You know, I listen to him every day. I love him. Yeah, he's a really nice guy. I really like the way he respects his mom.
Born in the heat of the desert, my mother died with a new life. Pride in the life of father, blame for the loss of his wife. You know, Lord, I've been in a prison for something that I've never done. It's been one hill after another. I've climbed them all one by one. Yeah, this time, Lord, he gave me a mountain.
got tired of the heartaches, tired of the grief and the strife, oh Lord. So tired of working for nothing, just tired of being my wife. She took my one ray of sunshine, she took my pride and my joy, she took my reason for living, she took my small baby boy.
Thank you. You're a good audience. Thank you very much. Yeah, thank you very much. My third movie was called Jailhouse Rock.
I give Elvis a lot of credit for bringing blues into rock and country. He's the first guy to ever do that, and I admire him for it. He has a lot of courage, and he's my number one. He's my number one singer of all time. Hope to name my kid after him someday.
I still live at home, and I have a fairly good job with the post office, and just about all the money that I do make goes for seeing the Elvis shows, but it's worth it. It's worth every penny of it.
I just love the guy. I mean, I know that sounds kind of weird, but I just love the guy, and I wish him many years of success.
I would say he is religious to the point where, of course, he can't go to church like many other people can every week, but you can see, by the way, he sings a lot of these spiritual songs, songs such as How Great Thou Art and From Time to Time You'll Never Walk Alone.
I have about four of his gospel albums, and my favorite is How Great Thou Art. It makes you feel good when he sings it. It brings tears to your eyes.
Oh, Lord, my God, when I always wonder, consider all the big world street. I see the stars, and I hear the rolling thunder. I pass around the universe display.
Sing it, fellas.
When Christ shall come with shout of acclamation to take me home, what joy shall fill my heart?
Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim,
The official Elvis Presley fan club of Great Britain and the Commonwealth is probably the world's largest Elvis Presley fan club. We boast a membership in excess of 12,000 members, and that's a live membership. It's not one that we keep adding members to each year. Once each year, we bring a charter flight to the United States, and that's what we're doing here in Cincinnati today.
All the way through Scotland! All the way through Scotland!
We all expected Elvis Presley to be about 12 feet tall, with an aurora around his head and a fanfare, but of course it wasn't like that, and he was everything that everybody says he was, a very natural, quite shy sort of person.
In the early morning rain, with a bell in my heart, and the harvest inside, all alone we go home. My love and soul. In the early morning rain, with no place to go, out on runway number 9, big 707 but I'm out here on the grass, where the pavement never grows. Can't jump a jet plane like you can a freight train, so I'd best be on my way in the early morning, so I'd best be on my way.
That country song. I really don't want to know.
Oh, how many arms have held you and had you let you go? How many? Oh, how many? I wonder, is it you? What a
I'd like to introduce you to my father. He's been sick for a while, but he's doing very well. Would you say, Daddy? Take care of you tonight. Is there any way for him to get up here? Is there any way for him to get up here? Just put a chair right here. I really missed him because it's been a couple of years since he's been able to go on tour with me. You know, he's been sick. I'd like you to say hello to my girlfriend Ginger. Ginger, stand up, honey. Sit down, Ginger. It's enough for her. Yes, darling, I'm so hurt because I still love you so. Even though you hurt me, you're like nobody else could ever do. I would never,
I'm gonna
Thank you very much. This next song was recorded by Frank Sinatra, and it's called My Way. I don't know the words to it, so I have to read it if you don't mind.
And now the end is near, and so I face the final curtain. My friend, I say it clear, I state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived, life is full, I traveled each and every highway and more. It's more than this, I did it my way. Regrets, I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do and saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway. Oh, and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I bit off more than I could chew. Had my fill, my share of losing, and now, as tears subside, I find it all so amusing to think I did all that, and may I say, not in a shy way. No, not me, I did it my way. Oh, what is a man? What has he got? If not himself, then he has not. To say the word he truly feels, and not the word the world reveals. The record shows I took the blows and did it my way.
Thank you very much. We'll meet you again. May God bless you. Adios.
Wise men say only fools worship. But I can't help falling in love.
Well, we knew he had a good voice for singing, you know, because he did do a lot of singing, like in church. And he made his first public appearance when he was 9 years old. It was a school competition type thing, and he won a third prize, singing Old Ship. And he, at that time, he couldn't even make no kind of music, you know. He just sung the song and it was it. One thing that was good, he never changed his feelings about people or about anything, really, you know. I'm sure he was very happy with his success and all the things that's happened to him, but good. But it didn't make him think he was something that he wasn't, you know. I lived with him till my wife died in 1958, his mother, which we had been married for 27 years. And then in 1958, he went to Germany in service. I went over there with him. And when we come back in 1960, I remarried. That's when I moved out of Graceland, and I haven't lived in Graceland since then. But I live, my land joined his. I live right at his back doors. So we're still together. I know he can't go out like an ordinary person, you know, because people see him, and of course they recognize him, and they worry him about this and that. And there's been so many different news reports out that they've made him into a hermit type guy, like Howard Hughes was supposed to be in, you know. I don't know how this stuff all gets started, but it's not really true. Ever started in the latter part of 54, and he went through 55, was doing pretty good, you know, locally, Arkansas, Texas, Mississippi, just touring the country. Uh-huh. Is where he met Colonel Parker. In 1955, Colonel Parker was booking shows down through Florida. He had people like Hank Snow, Marty Robbins, just a whole package deal of the Grand Ole Opry stars. So he booked Elvis with acts, you know. At that time, Elvis's manager was named Bob Neal. He was a disc jockey there in Memphis. So Elvis got to liking the Colonel, and the Colonel got to liking him, so that's where it started. Colonel Parker is an honest man, and I think that's where the big organization and the big togetherness comes, you know. Once you find out, you don't have to worry about a guy being your manager, what he's going to do for you. He handles it, you do the show, and everything works well.
Ladies and gentlemen, Elvis has left the building. Thank you and good night. We'd like to remind you, for following this concert, the Elvis Super Souvenir concession stands will be open for a short while.
The following message was recorded by Mr. Vernon Presley at Graceland in Memphis, Tennessee, just a few days ago.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to take this opportunity to thank you for all the cards and letters that you have sent since the passing away of my son, Elvis. We have all the flowers and the letters and the cards, which we will eventually get around to answering the majority of them. But I just wanted you to know that we appreciate them very much, appreciate your concern, and you have been a great help to me and the family during this time of grief. And I'd like to thank CBS for allowing me this opportunity to do this, to let you know that we did receive your cards and all the flowers. And ladies and gentlemen, this picture that you have just seen is the last live performance that Elvis ever done on stage. Thank you. God bless you.